Hello and welcome. I'm Dr. Mohol Banker, interventional radiologist from Ahmedabad. So today I'm going to discuss the case about the venous malformation of the face. So she is a young patient presented with the swelling over the left cheek and inside the mouth. This is the intraoral component of the lesion. Patient has occasional pain but no tenderness, sometimes difficulty in chewing. And on color Doppler, there are multiple tortuous channels seen within the lesion. Phlebolith also seen within these channels. And on color Doppler images, there is a venous spectrum is seen. So this is a classical of venous malformation. MRI confirmed the findings with the high intensity signals on the T2 weighted images. And along with some cheek region, some portion of the lip is also involved. And in past history, she has already taken one sclerotherapy with the Sertrol 2 years back, but it was not effective. So what's the next? So here is the list of sclerosing agent with the reducing strength, where the ethanol is the strongest one and bleomycin is the weakest one. So I have selected the absolute ethanol to treat this patient. Absolute ethanol is very, very lethal and very, very powerful embolizing agent to treat the vascular malformation. Vascular malformation has a primitive endothelium. So its internal lining has an embryological characteristic. So if we don't destroy it, it will regrow and it will regrow the faster. So our main target is to destroy the intima of the vascular malformation. And either in surgery or the other with the other embolic agents and the glue, it is not possible to destroy the inner lining of the vascular malformation. Only absolute ethanol is helpful to destroy internal lining. So in technique, with the direct puncture angiography, first have assess how much contrast is required and which are the outflow track and channels from this lesion. According to that, decide the dose of the ethanol and speed of the injection of the absolute ethanol within the lesion. With the negative roadmap technique, we can track the absolute ethanol within the lesion. Here the white color which you are able to see on the angiography, there is a negative flow map technique. And after the 3 ml of injection of absolute ethanol within the lesion and waiting for 10 minutes where I have injected the contrast, almost 50% of lesion is not filling up. So that portion is obliterated. Still, there's a few portion of the lesion is filling up. So I've injected the again 2 ml of 2 ml of absolute ethanol, and after that, when I've rechecked it, almost 80% of the lesion is not filling up. So that portion is obliterated. In the follow-up, in the sequel also, is a full angiographic image. Lesion is fully filled up with the contrast. After first injection, almost 50% of lesion is obliterated, and after second injection, almost 80% of the lesion is obliterated. Clinically also, left hand side you can see preoperative images with the intraoral component of the lesion is very large, and after 1 month, that lesion size is significantly reduced, and still there are many more session is going on. While injecting the absolute ethanol within the lesion, this important principle is called margin of safety. When the engineers build a bridge over the river, they know the maximum truckload going to pass from this river over this bridge is not more than 10,000 kg capacity, but still they built 15,000 kg capacity bridge, and this over capacity is for the margin of safety. Similarly, many literature journals suggest that 1 ml per kg per session is a recommended dose, safe dose for absolute ethanol. I use 0.5 ml per kg, and that is also 0.1 ml per kg at every 10 to 15 minutes interval to reduce systemic and local complication. It may require more seating, but the complication rate is significantly reduced. Absolute ethanol injection, it is very painful, so always done under the general anesthesia. And if the multiple nidus is there within the lesion, then choose the nidus near the symptomatic site like pain or swelling first. This is very important concept while treating the vascular malformation. Don't confuse with the path and the target. Most of the time, confusion arises between the path and the target. That means between the feeding vessels and the nidus. So absolute ethanol should always be injected into the nidus to prevent the complication. Never inject into the normal feeding vessels. And this is a classical quote by Yogi Berra that in theory, there is no difference between theory and practical. But in practical, there is a difference between these two. So as I have told you, that many theoretical journals suggest you 1 ml per kg is the maximum permissible dose per session without alcohol toxicity. But I use, practically I use 0.5 ml per kg. That is also 0.1 ml per kg at every 10 to 15 minutes interval. It reduces significantly down the complication rate. Thank you so much.